We're now going to talk about the consolidate conditional expression refactoring. A common situation in code is that you have a set of conditionals with the same result. What that means is that sometimes the code contains a series of conditional checks in which each check is different, yet the resulting action is the same. In these cases, the code could be improved by combining the conditionals, using, for example, AND and OR connectors, so as to have a single conditional check with a single result. At that point, you can also extract those conditionals into a method and replace the conditional with a call to that method. Consolidating the conditional code in this way can make the checks clearer by showing that you're really making a single check rather than multiple checks. And extracting that condition and having a method instead of a condition can clarify your code by explaining why you're doing a given check rather than how you're doing it. You can see an example of that situation in this code, which is the disabilityAmount method. As the name of the method says, the purpose of this code is to compute the disability amount for a given, for example, employee. And there is a set of initial checks in the methods whose goal is to decide whether this disability amount should be instead zero. And as you can see, there's multiple conditions. For example, there's the check about the seniority level, about the number of months that the employee has been disabled so far, whether the employee is part-time. And the outcome of all this check is always the same. If they're true, if the check is satisfied, then there's no disability amount. So the disability amount is zero. So what I will do if I apply the consolidate conditional expression to this method is that I will take this three conditionals. I will put them together by saying basically that if seniority is less than 2 or months disabled is greater than 12 or is part-time is true, then the return should be 0. And once I have this combined conditional, as I say here, I will just extract that into a method.